If you have ever taken any sort of research class, your professor probably didn't have a lot of nice things to say about using Google. Google can be great for a lot of things, but it can be hit or miss when it comes to academic research. But Google has a special page called Google Scholar that totally changes that. Google Scholar puts in information from many different academic sources and across many different disciplines. It is a great place to go when you don't know where to start. Be aware that not everything in Google Scholar is a journal article, and not everything is peer-reviewed. Some citations are books, others are patents, or case law, or even abstracts from conference presentations. It's better than just searching plain Google, but you can still get some pretty random results. Also, it may not have the most recent articles, since it can take up to 6 to 12 months for Google Scholar to index materials. To get to Google Scholar, you can search for it just via Google, but I recommend going to the library's link. This will bring up all of the full text that ISU has access to. In other words, you are much more likely to find the full PDF article. From the library's homepage, select the Databases tab you see along the top. Click the drop-down menu, scroll down to Google Scholar, and hit Go. One of the greatest strengths of Google Scholar is that it is super easy to use. Let's do a search on ways to prevent burnout in nurses so I can demonstrate how easy it is. I'll just type prevention, burnout, and nurses. Google is good at recognizing synonyms and different spellings, so as you can see in some of the bolded words, it has also searched preventative and preventing. Yay for Google! By default, Google searches by relevance. This means that it will put the articles that most closely match what you typed near to the top. You can also sort by date, but generally I leave it by relevance. One of the things I do change sometimes is the custom range. You can type in a range of years and Google will only bring up sources that were published within that time period. You can totally do a basic Google Scholar search by just typing in some words that best match your topic, and it's probably going to find stuff. But if you do want to run a fancy search, you have a few more options. To run an advanced search, select the three lines over here on the left and go down to Advanced Search. This brings up a box of additional search options. I'm going to change my search now and try to find articles on how the health literacy of patients affects their health outcomes. I want health outcomes for sure. That means I'm telling Google Scholar to find anything that mentions the word health and anything that mentions the word outcomes. I don't really care what order those are in, I just want both of those words to appear in these articles. The next line down is the exact phrase option. This is an amazing and wonderful thing to do. If you have ever searched using quotes, it's kind of similar. So again, I want to find information on health literacy, and I want this to appear as a phrase. So I'm going to type in health and literacy. If you want, you can get even more detailed. Use the with at least one of the words option. This is looking for synonyms, so that could be in children or youth or adolescents. Without the words is asking Google to not include words. This is okay, but use it with caution because sometimes you can eliminate sources that could be really helpful. The where my words occur. I love this because if you want something really specific, you can ask it to only bring up sources where all of the words you've typed in occur in the title of the article. It can be a fun place to start because if there is a title that has all these words, chances are it is a very good match for your topic. Then you can go on if you have a particular author you're looking for or a particular journal that you want the information from, you can put it here. Just like before, you can also limit by date. I will search from sources from 2015 to 2020. And let's see what we find. Okay, it only found 250 results. For Google Scholar, that's pretty amazingly low because we were so specific. And you can see how this fancy search up here got translated into what Google actually searches on. If it turns out that the all in title thing just over-narrowed your search and either gave you zero results or just too few, you can come up here and just delete that. And if I start looking through some articles, you will see some of these titles are pretty relevant to what I'm interested in. So now let's talk a little bit more about what we're actually looking at when we're looking at Google Scholar results. As long as you're logged into the ISU Library's Google Scholar, you are going to be able to see these Find It at ISU links. That means we have access to these articles and you should be able to get the PDF or full article if you just click on that link. You are also going to see some PDFs and HTMLs, that just means we have some other versions as well. Alright, let's look at this article so we can talk about some of the other things that Google Scholar offers. It's a very simple database to search, but it's actually doing some pretty powerful things in the background to make your search even better. The Cited By feature in Google is pretty much my favorite thing ever. If there's an article that is super relevant to your search, like this one is for me, then you might want to click on the Cited By link. This will show you all the articles and sometimes books and other sources that have cited the original article. This is a really great thing not only to find articles that are similar to your topic, but you can also track the development of ideas and concepts over time by following this path forward. If you want to track the article backwards through time, you of course look at the reference list, which includes what this particular article has cited. If you can't get the PDF, like in this case, it looks like we would be able to, but if you're unable to, this is what I would do. I copy the article title I'm interested in, and then I click on this Web of Science link. This is going to show up if you are logged into the ISU version of Google Scholar. It's a separate database, and it also does some of the same things that Google Scholar does. If I go to the new search and paste the original article title, there it is. Now I can tell you how many times it has been cited, and also the references that this particular article cited. These will include older information, but sometimes they can be really helpful in expanding your search, especially if you're stuck on something. The related article feature searches for other articles that use similar phrases or terms. This is not an exact science, but it can lead to interesting results, and again, it can help you find other things related to your topic. Google offers different versions of many articles. These are different URLs which may or may not lead to different sites. Be aware that some of these may be the peer-reviewed final version, but others may be earlier drafts of the article before it entered into the peer review realm. Some of these may be from the journal's website or the author's page or institutional repository. Just make sure to put your critical thinking cap on when you're looking at alternate versions. Google Scholar also wants to help you with your citations. Isn't it so friendly? Don't get super excited yet, because they don't always get it quite right. So while it's a great start, you still need to know how a citation looks in your particular style to make sure that it has no errors. Another cool feature that Google offers is the ability to save articles. This is great when you are in the middle of a search and you don't want to read every single abstract or track down every PDF. You just want to keep searching and building a list of articles that may be relevant. Then, when you have time, you can go back and see if they're relevant or not. You'll need to be logged into Google to do this. Then you can just click on the star, and once you're ready, you can go back and look at the saved articles by selecting My Library. The last feature is the search alerts. So let's say this is a great search, this is exactly what I'm looking for, and this is something that I'm interested in and will continue to be interested in. When the new research comes out, I can create an alert. This is what my search looks like. I can email it to myself. I can say I want 10 or 20 results. When it's no longer relevant to me, I will come back and I can delete it. Okay, so that is pretty much everything there is to know about Google Scholar. It's not the fanciest database, but it can be a huge help, and it's totally free to search. Students, remember the free part after you graduate. You won't have access to the full articles that you do now, but don't forget that you can use your public library to request articles via interlibrary loan. This is a wonderful service, especially if you're not affiliated with a university library. Don't hesitate to contact the ISU library closest to you if you have any questions.